was a very fine day, and Captain Maus Tiahahu had just arrived from his duty as a warrior in the war against the cruelty of Netherlands people in the early 19th century. With a red band that she always wore, a young girl greeted her father, the captain, with her bridal face. "How is it like to literally work for the country?" she asked. He answered, "Everybody who does all their work nice, giving their spirit towards the country, longing for freedom, is working for the country, everybody." So, who was this Marta? Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, judges, teachers, and all of you. My name is Winnie. I'm from Mariona High School. And I'm going to tell you a very beautiful story about a brave American heroine whose name was Marta Christina Tiahahu. Because of her respect and inspiration towards her father, to make a long story short, Marta decided to be the part of the back of his trumpet. Marta was only 7 when she, along with her father and other war leaders, came to an urgent discussion in the midst of the battle to come up with this strategy. The village of O, in the southeastern part of Saparua Island, had become yet another war, yet another victim, yet another confrontation. Fighting, which means not one, but minimal strikes of shots, shouts of painful cries, bullets passing through the hands of the innocent, deeds with no mercy, homes exploding with heartbreaking fires, and lost children in desperate search for their mothers. Mom! Mom! The unforgiving inhuman Dutch soldiers burned the village until all their homes were flat on the ground. Marta had witnessed this, and it's still her determination to never give up. In the midst of the chaos, of the uncontrollable turmoil, of the Moluccan smoke, Marta steadied herself. She looked around and shouted to the people of all, "This is our land! This is land on which we were born! Don't let your colonialists take it away from us!" So the Moluccans were motivated to be filled up again. They stood up for the sake of their homeland state and attacked them. "Liberty or death!" That was the motto that learned to keep their spirits up. Marta focused on the efforts of the Moluccans, the danger of her outside, who did help them and told them to stand back up. "We were born here, and therefore we shall be willing to sacrifice our permanent and on the side of the earth. It's much better to die in struggle against them than become their prize." But Marta and the other fighters were finally defeated by the force. Some heroes were killed, and some were taken in captivity in the island of Java. And how miserable it was for Marta to watch as her father was the one that threatened to be killed. From the distance, constrained by a barrier, she saw it all. How they beat her father and treated him in the most disrespectful way. "Let go of my father!" she cried. "In exchange for me being kind to them, let me die for him!" She wept in her heart. But to the Dutch, a daughter's love for a father meant nothing. They had no feelings, no mercy. The matter of seconds, of the most painful seconds, the martyrs, the sound was finally heard. The bullet had gone through the captain's head. For a moment, she felt nothing, saw nothing, she heard nothing. The young lady's heart had been ripped apart. "Did I just see that? It was a dream, wasn't it? Where's my father lying down there? Where did my great man go?" And so, that was the end to the hero who had been everything to Marta. The one that taught her faith, life, and struggle could not be longer alongside her. To say that they would do it together, they would bring the enemy down together, that the Moluccans would stand up, She wanted to talk in her father's travel. Unfortunately, the Dutchmen were able to seize her troops. The Dutch then placed Marta on the ship that brought to Java Island. But Marta was sick on board. She didn't want to eat or drink. She even refused to take medicine. Finally, she was seriously ill, and she passed away. The Dutch then buried her dead body in the sea in Buru Island and Tiga Island. Following independence, the Indonesian government declared the Maluku freedom fighter a national hero, and the anniversary of her death on 2nd January is commemorated as Marta Christina Tiahahu Day. We must continue to remind our young generation about the spirit and essence of Marta's struggle, as there will be the next